404K².
What are you, some kind of robot? Is that what it's like out there now? A world of robot overlords? I knew it.
And now, you're pretty much caught up.
Hello, welcome to Fallout 4K². I'm Kyle.
I'm Kira.
And we are going to do the Far Harbor DLC today. So, we're going to take Nick, and mm-hmm. we've already lightened up on supplies so we can pick up
the
more
Commonwealth
junk.
The Commonwealth is dying a slow death.
And we're ready to go on an adventure. So,
yep.
I'm looking forward to the next mission.
If you ain't been up to see Grey God, you should go.
Okay, so, first thing it wants us to do is listen to the radio.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Robots. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat. This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat.
Okay, it's a really All right. short message. Usually they're a little longer than that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's go.
Yep. I'm glad they didn't just beam Nick to Diamond City.
Oh, that would have been horrible. I would have hated that. I would have been so angry.
I know. Because you've been super angry whenever they've done it with Piper.
Oh, you know what? What if you can't bring companions? I didn't even think about that.
Well, I guess we'll have to leave Nick.
I think
if there's anyone it will allow us to bring, at least it should be Nick.
I'm just saying that in the old Fallout games, you couldn't. And one of the first things that people modded in was allowing you to do that. So, let's see if Bethesda learned their lesson there.
Yeah?
Considering Bethesda's track record, I understand if you don't really believe in them that much.
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Here, who's the client?
Sit down. We need to have a proper meeting.
Who's our client? A fisherman. Whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess... Missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Kenji Nakano?
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but... No. I'm not sure it was important.
It's probably the most important thing ever.
What was it?
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
Well, I thought I heard him say something about a daughter and also a radio, but I might have misheard him. Not sure how the two would be connected.
Okay, I'm on it.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
Miss Perkins.
Be careful when you head over to the Nakano residence. That whole area is pretty isolated.
Okay, my guess is they're missing their daughter, and it has something to do with something she heard on the radio.
That's almost exactly the plot from Point Lookout. You had to go to a guy on the edge of the coast, a fisherman. You were still on a quest to find someone's daughter.
Really?
Yep. Which was Point Lookout being one of the DLC in Fallout 3. From what I've seen of the trailers, this looks like it's going to be a lot like it, but we'll see. We'll hold off our judgment. We'll see how much they copy and paste it. Kidding.
It'd be hilarious if we go there and it looks exactly the same.
I mean, Point Lookout was a huge area. The only problem was it was kind of sparsely populated. But it still had a lot of stuff, even if it was sparse.
Mm.
Okay. So, I guess we'll just go on the coast.
Yep.
Oh, we're using the Ripper now. That might be good to switch it up from the sword.
Yes, and I love the Ripper. See, this is closer to the original design.
Oh, yeah, because unlike the L-shaped one that it keeps showing us in the loading screens.
Yeah.
It's dark. Nuka-Cola.
Mm-hmm.
And Nuka-Cherry, which has never been heard of before Fallout 4.
Really?
Well, actually, no. I think it was. Yeah, it was just called Cherry Nuka-Cola, though.
Ah. I wonder what this.
You can get all of our viewers tired if you keep yawning.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Is that him over there? What is this?
Someone important.
You think you can just jump on our claim on the USS Constitution and get away with it?
Get her!
What? To be the day you die.
I can't.
There's some scavengers after us somehow, even though we killed them all.
Coast looks clear.
So I'm guessing any scavengers we find from now on are going to be hostile.
Suppose someone should make use of it.
Okay. What's the best way? Wow, it's really far up north. Okay, let's go along the road. I think that might be better.
Mm-hmm. What jerks.
Oh, wait. No, let's try going along the beach. Lovely stroll on the beach. Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. Those scavengers were jerks, though. I'm glad we ended that the way we did.
Eh, who cares?
Okay, oh, wow. I don't think I remember hearing this one.
Welcome to your last stand. Hold on!
Come on.
Here you go!
Ah, nice. Can we snipe that guy from over here?
Possibly.
Oh, that reload.
I don't think we're alone.
Eh, it'll take forever whittling him down.
Yeah.
Not worth the ammo.
Detection system must be on the fritz.
A lot of people like the beach. I don't know. Maybe it's just because I've lived on the coast all my life, but it gets overrated pretty quickly.
I love the beach, as you well know.
What gets annoying is when people are like, oh, you live on the beach? That must mean you go, like, every day, right? No. Because I live there, I go less frequently. Because I live there, it makes it not valuable anymore. It's commonplace for me.
I've never lived close enough to a coast to have that.
I think we're getting close.
Oh, that must be their house.
And there's the boat.
Damn it! Come in! I know you're listening on the other end. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours. Stop. You need sleep.
She's out there, Ray. Someone has her. They could be raiders, or gunners, or God knows what else.
That was
really
loud.
I hope you don't mind. We let ourselves in.
Nick, thank God. You need to get to work right away. She could be hurt. She could be...
Whoa, slow down. Kenji, was it? Why did you go over the details with me and my partner here?
You brought a partner? Good. The more eyes, the better.
So,
what's the story with you and Nick?
Nick didn't tell you? Ran with him on one of his cases a few years back, searching for some sort of lost heirloom. He needed a boat. Things didn't end well. We were double-crossed by the client once we had what he was looking for. I still have some lead lodged into my hip.
Right. Yeah, it's starting to come back to me. Sorry things ended sour.
We got out. That's all that mattered. And now you can return the favor by finding my daughter.
Okay. Here to help.
We're here to help. Tell us what happened.
It's all thanks to this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive, and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
I'm not sure if this is the voice actor's fault, but I think it's pronounced Nakano, not Nakano.
Any leads?
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
We'll find her.
We'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs, if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Don't worry, Kenji. We'll get to the bottom of this. Just sit tight.
Okay. Well, ask questions.
Mr. Nakano.
Did you have questions? About my daughter.
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife said she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers?
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Rei. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her. Got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something, like she usually does. Someone made contact with her, and then they took her. God, what kind of twisted psychopath has my daughter?
Anything more you could tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack. He passed away recently. He used to scavenge the ruins in the south for parts. I kept telling him he was getting too old.
No more questions right now.
Work quickly, detective.
Mrs. Nakano.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
Tell me about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. I'd shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong, focused, careful. That's how I know she's still alive. But why would she leave without telling us? Maybe we... No, never mind. I don't want to waste your time.
Tell me. Every detail is important, Mrs. Nakano. Don't hold back.
It's just that we've been fighting a lot more. All of us. Ever since Kasumi's grandfather passed away, he was the only one that could really talk to her. Kenji and I don't understand machines, but those two could work together for hours. She started staying in her grandfather's boathouse late into the night. I thought she was just trying to cope with the loss, but now I wonder what she was up to.
Nothing else right now.
Well, that was a lot of information about what's been going on.
Yeah, it apparently we got the information, so we can go ahead and check out the boathouse. But I still want to take a look around here. Hopefully we can still look at whatever they wanted us to look at.
Yeah.
I like that.
Project Log, Radiation King Television. Mom says these things actually used to broadcast pictures and sounds back before the war. She also mentioned that some of the ruins of the television studios are still around if you head to the city. Of course, she wasn't too happy when I asked if we could make a trip out there. I'm getting off track. I managed to repair the vacuum tubes and got the power working again, but, well, it's not like there's any working signal for this thing to receive. I'm just going to start stripping this thing for parts moving forward. Hello? Testing? Project Log. Holotape player. Managed to strip out the parts from this thing and make something that's easier to move around. Granddad always said you need to make a record when you start something. You know, in case you have to go back to it. So, I guess I'm going to start doing that. Maybe I should start with an inventory of all the parts I found?
Kasumi! Your father needs help with the boat!
I'll be right there! Oh, damn. Was I recording that? Ugh.
The kitchen.
Project log. Kitchen mixer. The circuits are still good, but all the mechanical parts are rusted through. Maybe I can...
All right, everyone. I'll be back in a few days. Was there anything else we needed from the city?
Wait, you're going now?
No!
Wait, Dad, I could come with you.
It is better if I go alone, Kasumi. Do not worry. I have your list.
You don't know what half that list is, Dad. I can help you. Really, I'll be...
I said no. I'm sorry. You're safe here, okay? Just stay put for me.
Okay.
I know you're disappointed, but I won't be long. I love you.
I love you too, Dad. Project log? Lamp. Yep, it's a lamp. Filament plus power equals light. I swear, sometimes I think my parents break these things just to keep me busy.
She definitely didn't like her father.
Looks
going
like this
to
is Kasumi's room. Let's see if she left any clues about where she went.
Project log, dreams. Recording what I can remember when I wake up. I keep having the same one. I'm in a white room. People are talking about me like I'm not there, or maybe they just don't care. And then there's this, I don't know, jolt, like a spark of electricity to the back of my head, and then everyone turns to look at me. God, I hope I don't have it again tonight. project log? Radio. Correction, working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be... let's go with... Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common.
Hmm. I feel bad for her because she just wanted to leave you know?
You know, they put a lot of work into her character background. Like, seriously, we haven't even met her. We know so much more about her than most characters in this game.
Yeah, that's true. Look at all the cats on the walls.
Oh, yeah, that's funny. I don't know if there's anything worth looking at in here.
I guess the logs were what we were looking for.
As long as you're carrying it.
Okay, I just thought Nick might react to something.
Hmm.
Okay, I think we're good here, I guess. Let's go out to the boathouse.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't have a log about the bathroom, does she? But no, seriously, that was cool. That's a lot of background to her. I can really feel for her.
Yep. You can tell she's like the misunderstood genius of the family because she understands all that stuff. And the only other person who did was her grandfather, and now he's gone.
Reminds me a lot of Gone Home. You ever play that?
No.
It has the whole misunderstood girl thing that you find through logs throughout her house.
Hmm.
Actually, I wouldn't be surprised if it was like a blatant reference.
But, shouldn't there be logs out here?
Maybe.
Like, this was her work area, wasn't it?
So much duct tape.
Well, that's good. Oh.
My dear Kasumi, if you ever get locked out of the safe, then the answer is here in the boathouse. Picture where the key is.
Love, Granddad. Picture where the key is.
Is there a picture in here?
Oh, is that it? I thought it was going to be like having to imagine what Kasumi would think of where the key is.
Oh. Oh, okay. I think... Yeah, there we go.
Good work.
That's cool.
Now, let's see what's in that safe.
I think it would have been cooler if what they did is just place the key, like, right behind it. Because that's something that would have been incredibly annoying to find normally, except for when you're using your head.
Yep.
But we literally couldn't even examine it, so.
Yeah. Oh, her final holotape and... some more duct tape.
No offense, but if I was naming the holotapes that I was recording, I'd be a little concerned if I named one, "This is my final holotape." Wait.
It's the top one.
Project log? Myself. I never really thought about who or what I am, but... God. Where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synths. Synthetic people. Made by the Institute. They're trying to build a place for their kind. Where they can be themselves and be accepted for what they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then... they started asking about me, and some questions came up. Questions I don't have answers to. I mean, I've always felt off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then there are things in my childhood I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams. I'm going to go to meet these synths. I have to know the truth about myself. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Far Harbor. I can make my way to them from there.
So the daughter takes off by boat. But more importantly, there's a colony of synths up near this far harbor. We need a way to get there. Let's go talk to Kenji. He knows the waters better than anyone.
Okay, so she thought she might have been a synth.
Yeah, she might be a synth. Or maybe she was replaced with a synth and they decided just to raise the synth replacement.
I guess maybe they didn't even know she was a replacement.
Well, either way, maybe I think they do. I'm suspicious of the parents because they keep her so sheltered. Maybe they know
maybe
how
the
hostile
dad
people
knows
are.
That.
Well, maybe they know how hostile people are against synths, and that's why they hide her.
Oh my god, that would be... Oh my god, you're right.
Have you finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
Not yet. We need to wait for Nick to get up here and stop his swimming so he can join the conversation. Nick? Hello?
I guess he just likes swimming.
There you are. Okay, let's go.
Let's ask if she's human.
Wait. Nick? Seriously?
Hey.
Go on.
Over here.
Done and done.
Okay.
Excuse me, Mr. Nakano.
Did you find anything?
Is she human?
I need to ask you an important question. Are you sure your daughter's human?
What kind of question is that? Why are you asking?
Your daughter made contact with a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter. We raised her. I gave birth to her. She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
Synths are still people?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if your daughter is a synth, Mrs. Nakano. She's still a person who needs help.
But my daughter isn't a synth.
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind. Did you find where Kasumi went, Detective?
I think Kasumi took off somewhere up north. Do you know what's up there?
Where specifically? I've been up the coast, almost to where the waters start to freeze, but that's a lot of miles.
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbor.
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat. You have to go after her. Please, take my other ship on the dock outside. My father's design. It has a guidance system, and it is built for distance.
What can I expect out there, Kenji?
I only made the trip to Far Harbor once, when I was a boy. All I remember is that my father did not want to stay long. Something about the air being bad.
I'll get to the bottom of this, Kenji.
Thank you. I know you haven't asked for a payment, and we can't offer much. But here, please take it. I insist. For expenses, if nothing else.
I know it'll be hard waiting for word, but try to carry on like normal. We'll be back as soon as we can.
Oh, we can tell
Fine,
the railroad
Kasumi.
About the synths.
Please.
Like I'm going to do that before we scat out the situation ourselves.
Yeah.
Excuse me, Mrs. Nakano.
My daughter is human. She's not a synth.
Okay, this is going to be your last words. Bye. Don't wish us luck or anything.
You know what?
What?
I wonder if maybe she is and she is replaced and the mother doesn't know about it, but the father knows.
Maybe. Yeah, cats.
Cats. I love cats.
Okay, let's save. Actually, you know what? Hard save before we leave.
Yeah.
Yay!
Bar Harbor!
Ooh. We don't need to stay at the controls. They control themselves. Nick! Bye, Nick. Gonna miss you.
Oh. He didn't get on the boat.
Nope. I like how the boat's driving itself. This is cool. I just wish I could
see
it.
Well, it was his grandfather's design, so maybe he designed it like that.
I can't jump. If I jump, I start falling off. I want to watch the front. Oh, man. Oh, great. Now we're going to have to see spoilers again with floating screens, aren't we?
Yeah, I guess so.
See? I had no idea they sold lobster. You know that lobster was actually considered a pest a couple hundred years ago? And now it's considered a delicacy.
I did not know that.
I'm serious. If you went back in time, you could buy so much lobster for so little money. I can imagine that being a get-rich-quick scheme for a time traveler.
Is Nick with us?
Oh, crap. Maybe he'll respawn.
Yeah.
Aesthetic.
Yeah.
Jesus, ease up, Alan. We got visitors.
Mainlanders ain't nothing but trouble.
Put the damn gun down.
Oh, there he is.
Are you lost? This is Far Harbor. We don't get many visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
Looking for Kasumi?
Why don't we ask about Far Harbor first?
What is this place?
Well, in ancient times, this used to be a tourist town. My people have lived here and on the island for generations. But now everyone's crowded onto the docks just trying to survive another day. We have more than our fair share of problems. You aren't here to add to them, are you?
Okay. A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kasumi may have passed through here. Her family hired me to find her.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well, she came through here all right.
At least we know she made it this far.
Damn it. Mariners ain't coming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You, help us defend the town and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hull never lets us down. Now follow me! Be careful on the hull, stranger. Don't fall off! If you do, we might not be able to rescue you in time.
Okay, I'm trying to follow you.
Man the hull! Something's out there!
Where are we going?
You sure you saw something?
This ain't a drill!
What the hell?
Eyes peeled, everyone!
Open the gate! I've got wounded out here!
Mariner, there's no time. Look to the fog. They're coming.
Gulpers!
Oh, God!
Fire at will!
What?
Got company!
Someone's coming.
Okay.
Gulpers.
Damn it, it's broken!
Shit! Yeah,
something's broken! Mess with me!
No. Hunters, look out!
Out of the way.
Oh, crap.
All right. Still in one piece.
It's over.
No. Eyes on the fog. Something's coming.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is fucking on.
Legendary.
Oh, crap.
It shoots.
sorry.
Should've just Nick run. Down there?
We're clear. All right. Well done, all. Open the gate!
Someone die?
I think so, yeah.
Ah. So, this is interesting. Like, fish. I guess that technically makes them not mire lurks, because mire lurks are usually amphibious.
Yeah.
Except the fact that they're on land now makes them amphibious retroactively.
Yeah, it's kind of weird type of, creature.
Could we have saved Jared? Did we fail?
I don't know.
Or was it scripted? I have no way of knowing.
Avery.
And now you see what we're up against. The fog and the creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. But for your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
Aww. The fog?
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it, the deep fog, that are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
Please tell me they didn't use fog to cut out making assets. It's a very common game mechanic to just put fog in so that you don't have to render as much graphics.
You've lost the whole island?
Oh, the fog's been here forever. There are good years when it recedes and the island's almost normal. Then there are times when it spreads all over, and people have to cling to any patch of land free of the fog. For the past, 8 years or so, it's been getting as bad as it's ever been. Now, Far Harbor's one of the only places left that's safe.
Oh, wow.
If you manage to survive despite all that, you must be tough.
Ornery, more like. I'm
done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Adam cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden the stranger with all this nonsense.
What's the deal with the Children of Adam?
They're religious folk. Worship the power of Adam. Which is radiation, I guess. If you want details, you'd have to find and ask them. We used to have a peace with them until a certain hothead menace named Alan Lee...
Now that's enough! That preacher came into the harbor saying that it was Adam's will that we lost our land. That it was Adam's goddamn will that we lost so many friends and family. And that the Adam would wipe this whole place clean of us.
If it were up to me, you'd hang for what you did to that preacher, Alan.
Is it really considered a threat if you're saying that your deity's going to do it?
I don't know.
Like, if I believed in Arceus and I said Arceus was going to kill all of you viewers, would that be considered a threat? Just because I
think so. At least if you genuinely believed it.
Maybe.
What did he do to the preacher?
Alan pulled a gun on him. He claims the preacher reached for his. We don't have police, or really any law, just custom and popular sentiment. And after everything the preacher said, it was abundantly clear doing anything to Alan would have made matters worse.
Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. There's not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie, Avery. The fog's gotten more lethal year over year. And now the fog's covering the whole island. But only after the children came.
You know as well as I do that's happened before. Sure, people have theories the children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
You know, if it was that big of a deal to you, Alan, maybe you should have charted it out and made like a line graph depicting like the amount of children increase as opposed to the amount of the square miles of fog increase, but that probably wouldn't have proved your point, so that's why you're just guessing, isn't it?
Yep. Okay, back to business.
Sorry.
Can we get back to business?
Sorry for all that. You're here for Kasumi, right? She headed inland to the Synth Refuge, Acadia. Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But a word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
What's old Longfellow's story?
He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. Some say crazy. If someone needs to get to Acadia, he's the only one that'll do it. But people around here are known for being stubborn, willful, and other less flattering things. But Longfellow's got a reputation even among us.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
Ask Longfellow. He's the only one that's been there.
That was productive.
Thanks for the info.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away, people like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
Okay, so there's going to be side quests.
Yeah.
By the way, they should have called it Arcadia. Then it would have been like a Bioshock reference as well as the, you know, Arcadia just makes more sense to Acadia. I don't know if that's correct or not, but whatever. Oh, we got a lot of optional stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so we could probably save the side quests for after we do the main quest if you want.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
And if the main quest involves, like, blowing up the town, then I guess we can just, like, oh wait, okay, let's do these quests first. Let's see if Nick says anything.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Got something for me?
Your thoughts?
Who do you think actually won the war? Nobody, I guess.
Just wanted to check in, see how you feel things are going between us.
Honestly? I don't think I could ask for a better partner, or a better friend.
You can't take care of yourself. Better you take the long walk.
I'm giving you one warning. Tony gets his boots back.
Your mom's not around no more, Smalls. I'm not afraid of you.
He might be thinking I'm just a stupid girl, thinking you can take me. But everyone's got to sleep. Make things right quick. Or else.
Shit!
Hey, pal.
No one talks to my brother, all right?
Hi there.
What are you gonna do about it? Wow, I waited for that? Okay.
Well, hello.
Doesn't talk to people.
Okay, so we don't have an option. That's bright.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's find this guy.
Yep.
It's a lot of backstory being dropped on us, but, it seems cool.
Yeah, I think it's pretty cool.
I always thought the anglerfish was really cool.
Hey there.
Hard times.
Excuse me.
The Plank's the only bar in town, so if you need a drink, don't be shy.
What do you have to drink?
All sorts of old world booze. We carry Vim, too. And before you ask, Vim is an Islander favorite. But it may pack more punch than the stuff you're used to.
Let's see what you have.
You got my attention.
I'll pass.
Yeah.
Mainlander, today's your lucky day. Free beer for ya!
Oh.
You have anything a bit stronger?
Pushing your luck, are ya? Ha! I like it. Take this. Top shelf all around. So, drink up! You stay here over long and the fog will claim ya. Might as well meet her with a belly full of fire, eh?
The fog?
What's so special about the fog on the island?
Can't you feel it? Even here, as safe as anyone can be on this damned island. It's alive. You walk inland and it'll blanket you up in no time. And if the clickety-click of the Geiger don't get you, the madness will. The island will claim us all in the end.
The fog can drive you crazy?
Yes. It's not natural. The trappers you find inland, some were always murderous louts. But many just got lost in the fog for too long. And the mine goes.
Okay,
if you have any sense, return where you came from and don't look back.
Oh, if it's so dangerous, why do you stay?
This is our home. If you call yourself a proper man or woman, you don't give up on that. Besides, we all gotta die. Might as well do it with your long knife deep in the belly of the beast that wronged you. Ha!
This is ha a lot.
Yeah.
I'd like a drink. Pretty...
Let's get you liquored up then. Ha!
He's, interesting.
Okay. Is this the guy?
If you need a room, see Mitch.
Oh, yeah.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia?
Heard there was a scuffle out there. You get your hands dirty? I'm done leading people to their deaths in the fog. Last fella couldn't keep up. Didn't last 5 minutes.
Can you tell me about Acadia?
Strange folk like there. Call themselves synths. Seems to me they just want to be left alone, to live their life in peace. They've done some good turns for us islanders. The fog condensers, most especially. Wouldn't even be a far harbor left without those.
What's a fog condenser?
The condensers? They're a tricky bit of science. They keep the fog away. Powered by the wind farm, the synth fellas got up and running. Us islanders don't particularly like being obligated to them. But there you have it.
That's cool.
Okay, looking for a runaway.
Some parents are worried about their runaway daughter. She went to Acadia, and I need to find her.
If someone's headed for Acadia, there's always a story. Yours worth dying over, huh?
You want to do B?
Know about Kasumi?
The runaway's name is Kasumi. You know about her?
Sounds like Captain Avery's been running her mouth again. She should know better than to stick her nose where it's not wanted. Maybe I heard her. Maybe not.
This girl's all her family has. You'd have to be a real wretch not to give a damn.
Bah. This goes against all reason. But I can get you to Acadia. But you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say it. Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Rad X and the like. And then the real work can begin.
Should I make any other preparations?
Ammo, stim packs, maybe a rocket or three. Worse than Myra lurks out there.
Do we have stuff? Or do we need to go buy anything?
We're fine.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me, then.
Okay. Let's go on adventures.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's synths, children of the atom, gulpers, and probably raiders out there in the fog. No offense, but the fog seems more populated than the town.
Yeah, well, it's taking up almost the entire island.
I'm scraping by.
Seriously? Okay, so we have to go inside the cell, watch him exit it, and then exit again.
Ah, your damn cat knocked something over. Again.
Okay, go.
Ah, Tink didn't mean anything by it, Mitch.
I swear, her tail's a menace. Does she even know it's attached to her bleeding hide? Everyone!
You want a bite?
Either
Mitch or I can take your order.
We're trying to have a conversation here.
Shut your mouths! Open your damned ears! So the fogs are coming for us all, and I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have another round. On the house!
Yeah!
Time?
He likes to give a lot of free drinks.
His business is probably failing.
He's probably like, screw it. I'm going to die anyway soon, so might as well let people have their fun.
I doubt he's in it for the profit.
Yeah.
It's just me, or do the footsteps sound incredibly loud?
We need to move through the main drag. Old Mountain Trail is where we're headed. The fog ain't like nothing you see in the Commonwealth. Mainlanders think a dose of Radaway is all you need. Tracks. Fresh ones. Trappers ahead. When the bullets start flying, find cover. Keep your head down if you want to live.
You think moving quickly through the fog would be essential to staying alive, but... He seems to just be taking his dang time.
Fresh lobster. They're open.
You're dead!
Now you got first.
Oh, crap!
Teach it. We ain't alone.
So, I'm guessing these are like...
Raiders.
Ocean themed raiders.
Probably.
You're playing hot.
There you are.
Hope you choke on your own blood.
His head came off.
Do you hear it? Does it speak to you?
Yeah.
Is he on top of the building? Yeah, he is.
I guess so, yeah.
You don't have to do this. Yeah! Yes! Fight for it! There you
go. Good.
You're not half bad. Looks like it. Figured I'd have to take care of a lot of them. Might just make a proper Far Harbor woman out of you. See the fog and do a number on you. Get you all turned around. Does something to your brain. Trappers were mean to begin with, but now... What was the...
Found you!
Here's the mob trails. We stick to this and we'll make it to Acadia. Game trails crisscross the
world.
Just
texture,
so don't be surprised if we got local wildlife to deal with.
Time to earn that next drink.
Oh, wolves.
We haven't seen wolves before, have we?
Still got it.
I mean, they're basically
you
just
like
a different
them
type
puppies?
Of
dog. We grow everything extra mean on the island. Still got a ways to go.
We've seen wolves.
I can't wait to get there.
We've seen wolves in mods before.
Hear that?
Oh, yeah, true.
They usually stick to the deep fog. Best we steer clear. But you never know.
So this is just regular fog. We're not in the deep stuff yet.
When I was a young lad, no higher than your knee, whole island was covered in fog. The fog eventually rolled back. People resettled. But they got comfortable. Started taking things for granted. Folk got short memories. All this has happened before.
So him blaming the children is bull crap because it's happened before.
Yeah.
There's something out there.
Look sharp!
Gophers got a
they got fire alerts.
They can grow 2-3 times the size of a man. Good thing you don't see too many of them around.
I'll be doing the world a service.
I don't know. It was a pretty good group that attacked us back at the hole.
Yeah, that's one way to get the coolant pumping.
I was hoping we'd find some new type of weaponry here.
Yeah. Maybe an Acadia.
Here you go!
Shit. It won't be bothering anybody now. Unless you're hounding for a green suntan, I suggest we get a move on.
I keep switching weapons because I don't know what type of enemy we're going to find. Oh,
well, it's a good idea to be versatile.
Stringing one more soul to their damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here? Another rad worshiping lunatic, that's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those, too?
Who's she?
One of them children of Adam preachers. Started off as pests. Now they're more like a menace.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
What'd Acadia do?
What's Acadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fog. You'd do well to avoid such creatures, and instead seek the only true master of this land.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children. And you may join our family if he deems you worthy.
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed, you will be rewarded with entrance into our family.
Ooh, you could join them.
No thanks.
Hey, wait. I like to join all the factions. I don't want to just say no thanks. I mean, just because we agree to sign up with them doesn't mean we're turning our backs on Far Harbor. Maybe we can be part of both groups and have them mediate.
Uh-huh. Well, I guess.
And maybe we'll get radiation resistance.
Okay, fine.
Fine? Don't just say
sign
fine.
Sign me up.
Suppose I've got nothing better to do.
Huh. Adam usually prefers those with a bit more fervor. But nonetheless, if you wish to test his favor, seek the nucleus.
If you're done wasting time with a fanatic, let's move on.
Hi.
Head to the nucleus. There, Adam's plan will be revealed.
The nucleus?
Up ahead, the air is clean. No fog. Acadia is not too far now.
I mean, we should always hear out a faction.
Yeah,
we have the opportunity
true.
To
I'm
join
just
them.
Distrustful.
It's our obligation to join any faction we can. We'll be better able to hear them out. And if we decide against them, then we just destroy them from the inside.
Excuse me.
Deep fog has all manner of nasties.
Come on, let's go.
And we've arrived. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again. You come see me. Got a cabin just outside of Far Harbor. Good place to tool up your gear, get some rest, or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you're bringing a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
Leaving already? Don't you want to see what happens next?
You saying you want me to stick around and watch your back?
Maybe later.
You should come with me. I can still use your help.
All right. Why the hell not? Beats drinking alone.
All right. Where do you want to send Nick to?
I kind of want to take Nick to meet the synths. I think he'll have more valuable conversation.
So, do you not want to bring him then?
I want him as a companion. I just don't want him right now.
Okay.
Oh, crap. Nick?
Nick.
Time to hit the road?
Yes.
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Okay. We need to make sure we send him back somewhere in Far Harbor, so.
His cabin.
Yep. Okay, so we'll travel with him later.
All right.
Yeah, let's just take Nick to meet the synths.
Mm-hmm.
It's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more. I play the Wild Rover, no, never, no more.
Okay, so this will be for next episode. We'll go meet the synths at Acadia.
Yep.
I gotta do research on the etymology of that. Anyway, this is Fallout 4K Squared. I'm Kyle.
I'm Kira.
Bye.
Bye.